According to a new EWTN News Real Clear Politics poll, Catholics remain divided on the abortion issue, but agree President Joe Biden should not run for re-election. This is the second of three surveys that will be conducted together by EWTN and RCP surrounding this year's midterm elections. This round of surveys found that 67% of Catholic voters support public funding for pregnancy resource centers, while 18% are opposed. When asked if they agree or disagree with the Supreme Court's decision to overturn Roe versus Wade, Catholic voters are almost evenly split. 48% say abortion should be a federally protected right, and 46% say each state should determine its own abortion policy. 6% were not sure. This is somewhat troubling given that the church clearly teaches that abortion should not be a right and that it is in fact the killing of an unborn baby, making it gravely wrong. Joining us now with analysis is Matthew Bunson, executive editor and Washington bureau chief for EWTN News. Matthew, thanks for joining me. This is the second survey that has been conducted after the overturn of Roe versus Wade. And 75% of mass attending Catholics say they favor the overturn of Roe, while 50% of those who attend a few times a year or less believe abortion should be a federally protected right. Are you surprised to see those numbers at all?
No, I'm not. And I say that because this is very consistent with the disparity in our polling that we have monitored now really since November of 2019 when we began working with Real Clear Opinion Research on these polls. What we find is that there is a significant gulf between those who attend Mass regularly and those who don't on almost every core issue, especially in the area of Catholic belief. So it is not surprising that those who attend Mass on a more regular basis are much more opposed to abortion. And in fact, a majority would be solidly opposed to abortion under any circumstances, whereas those who attend much less regularly, either once a year or never, tend to hold positions that are very clearly contrary to the teachings of the church, abortion included in that. So, no, I can't say that we're surprised, but we are, of course, disappointed.
Right. Really speaks to the importance of receiving the sacraments. I'm sure you would agree. And a majority of Catholic voters surveyed in this poll support public funding for pregnancy resource centers. Thankfully, 62% believe political and church leaders should be speaking out against the recent attacks on these centers, compared to just 15% who say they should not. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think this is consistent with what we're finding nationally. If we look at Catholics, and this is all Catholics, Catholic voters, there is a very strong level of support for pregnancy resource centers. This flies, of course, in the face of something of an orchestrated campaign against pregnancy resource centers that we're seeing most conspicuously led by Senator Elizabeth Warren. What I think it does is that it really flows from much of the Dobbs decision, in which now the question is going to be how we can support pregnant women, how we can actually help to help mothers in as they're trying to live their lives.
Yeah. And Matthew, when it comes to pro-life issues, what can we expect in the midterm elections based on this poll? Do you think that pro-life candidates are likely to win based on the results?
Well, I think it's been an interesting thing to try to chart as the campaign has gone on. The Democrats have clearly made abortion one of the linchpins of their campaign for the midterms, assuming, as they are, that the overturn of Roe v. Wade is going to galvanize much of their voter base. What we're finding, I think, in this poll is that abortion as an important element or an important issue for Catholic voters ranks only at 10%. It's tied with immigration. This election, it appears, is going to be focused much more intently on economic issues of inflation and the economy and jobs. Now, that I think would be a disappointment for the Democrats. Now, on the other hand, what we're also seeing, I think, is an opportunity for pro-life candidates to stark contrast, to make a contrast between themselves and their rivals politically on both sides. What I mean by that is that 87% of Catholic voters, this is across the board, want some kind of restriction or regulation on abortion. Now, obviously, our goal is that we end abortion completely. But that is a pretty stark contrast to what we're seeing with a lot of pro-abortion candidates in the United States, and that is that they want no restrictions of any kind on abortion. So the ground is being really staked out here, and it is an opportunity for pro-life candidates to create that contrast on this issue. Mm,
yes, and speaking of pro-abortion leaders, Matthew, a very important stat here. We also saw that a majority of Catholics believe President Biden should not run for re-election. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, this is one of the most interesting takeaways from this poll, that a majority of Catholic voters, and again, that runs across pretty much every category of Catholic voter, would not want President Biden to run for a second term. Now, an even higher, this is about 58%, but 67% of Catholic voters also don't want President Trump to run for election again. So that tells us that I think Catholic voters really want to turn the page in some ways politically on both this administration, the current one, and the previous one. So I think they're looking for a different slate of candidates. Now, it is important to note that President Biden is the second Catholic president in the history of the United States. So in that sense, these findings are really quite striking. Mm.
And is there anything else that you caught that caught your attention in this poll, Matthew? We have just about 30 seconds left.
Very briefly, I think the loss of support among Hispanic voters for the Democrats, President Biden in particular, is something of great importance and could be a decisive element in how the midterms turn out.
Mm. Well, thank you so much for your expert analysis on all of this. Matthew Bunson of EWTN News will continue to follow it as the election nears. Thank you.
Good to be with you.